Hi there. I'm Annelies, your conduit for change, and I am so glad you are here. May I have your listening for a little story? I'd like to tell you about a personal story about my life. A little bit about, you know, my story and where I came from and what I'm about and why I do what I do. So it wasn't too long ago that I was driving my little yellow smart car up through the iron gates and past security up to the governor's mansion to do hair and makeup for former governor. I did this for 3 governors in a row and did it for a lot of very successful, well-known, famous people, professionals, politicians, Broadway stars, film stars. They were all really successful, and they took their work really seriously as I did. They worked hard to get where they were and put on a good face. But behind closed doors, I saw a different world. I saw the stress, the anxiety, the struggle to stay at the top, and the veil that so many professionals put on to save face, to not share feelings, to not feel feelings. God forbid we slip from the plateau that we've created for ourselves. So I saw this play out over and over again, this fear of losing identity and place. And the truth is, we all put on that veil. We don't like to feel our feelings. And it's very common, more than many of us want to admit. I saw the drive and accomplishment clash with loneliness, addiction, hidden grief, and fear. For me, these vulnerable moments with my clients, they illuminated a missing piece and a place where there was something missing and an opportunity for me to serve and create human connection. In my work then and now, this is what I do. I have a unique gift for leading people through difficult situations, difficult conversations, and difficult moments that are just hard, because life can be hard and hard things happen. In an increasingly disconnected world, we need to remember that we need one another. We need to be reminded that we need to connect to ourselves, connect to each other, and connect to the greater world around us. Because it's true, sometimes productivity is down, and people don't like one another, and tensions are high, and stress is high. I get that. And at the end of the day, what really matters most is that we take a breath. We hold space and presence to see one another. People need to remember that professionals are people too. We're human beings, not human doings. Over my 43 years of life, I've been to 22 countries, been to practically every state in the US. I've even lived in Dubai. And in my exposure to the global human experience, I can honestly say that we all want the same thing. And that's to hold a sense of belonging, to have a sense of safety, and to be heard. So because of this insight and a desire to match the world's greatest need with my gift, I left Broadway. I left the business of doing hair and makeup to become a coach. Not just any coach, a strategic visionary, a catalyst, a conduit for change. And because of this insight and a desire to match the world's greatest need and my gift, it wasn't easy, but I went to school and it took 10 years for me to retool, to re-educate, to certify, and to gain my credentials. I learned and I wanted to study the creative process, how and why it worked. I mean, coming from theater and the creative arts, there's a lot I learned about the power of the creative process. I saw things move in ways that seemed magical. It's like, how come regular people don't know this? I wanted to use the creative process to be that catalyst, to be that change agent, and for people to remember their own creativity, their own presence, and to connect to mindfulness. Because it helps us work better together, to problem solve together, to hold empathy, and to build trust. So I studied all of that and wove my knowledge in with my worldly experience, and I started my business, Conduit for Change. And that's through which how I serve clients today. Listen, we all have our stage that we want to show. It looks pretty and perfect. And we want people to see that and not what's backstage, not what's messy and feels like it doesn't work. We want to hide that. But in hiding that, we're hiding our vulnerability. And where there's vulnerability, there's possibility. Creativity resides at the edge of chaos. And if we hold back and try to be perfect, then we don't access that magic. And I mean that in the most scientific way. It really is magical, and there really is science to prove it. So, having a safe place to be vulnerable is really important. To be heard and to envision new possibilities. And to have that co-pilot and that catalyst to sit with you, it's a game changer for life, for business. And that's what I do. I've been told that my coaching style is a compassionate poke with a sharp stick. And that is absolutely true. And the reason why is because it's co-creative. It's co-creative between me and you. And it takes a leap of faith from me and you. Whether that's me and a lot of yous, or just the two of us. We both are meeting in the middle, and that's where that magic happens. Remember, it wasn't too long ago that I was driving my little yellow smart car through the iron gates, through security, up to the governor's mansion. And so here, I can absolutely, undeniably tell you, I know change. I know vulnerability. And I know a leap of faith. And I ask you to take that with me now. What could be possible by saying yes? I look forward to connecting with you. I'm Annelies, your conduit for change, empowering people, fostering ideas, and changing lives. I thank you for your listening.